And now it's time for RTB 101. This is the segment where we talk about practical questions to help train you to share your faith with friends and family more effectively. And here to help me talk about a very common question is astronomer Dr. Hugh Ross. Welcome back, Hugh.
Thank you.
So we are old Earth creationists. We believe the universe is about 13.7 billion years old. But many Christians that I run into make the suggestion that, well, how do you know God only made the universe appear old? Maybe it's really young. Can you help me begin to think it through why these appearance of age strategies may not be the best approach?
Well, astronomy is unique in that we directly access the past. We're not inferring the past. We can't see the present. We can only see the past. And the farther away you look in astronomy, the farther back in time we're seeing. And we look really far away, like 10, 12, 13 billion light years away, everything measures to be really young. But as we look close by, things look to be middle-aged and old. So you can actually watch the universe get older and older as you go very far away and come up towards nearby objects. And that basically tells you God did not create with appearance of age, because it's kind of looking like at a photo album. You can actually watch the universe go from infancy all the way up to its present age.
So when we say something is 13 billion light years away, we're saying that that's how far or how long it's taken for the light to travel to here.
A galaxy 13 billion light years away, we're seeing it as it was 13 billion years ago.
Okay.
And so with a universe only 13.7 billion years old, you're basically seeing it when it's only a few hundred million years old. It's really young. Whereas our Milky Way galaxy has the appearance of having been around for 13 billion years.
So when we think about the appearance of age idea within a Christian theological framework, what does that do to our view of God? Because Scripture says the heavens declare the glory of God. But if things only look old, that kind of makes me feel like I can't really trust what I'm observing in the heavens.
You're on target, Krista. Eight times the Bible tells us it's impossible for God to lie or deceive. If you're actually saying God made things look old when in fact they're young, it means he's deceiving us.
Okay.
And the Bible explicitly says God never does that. So if something is young, it's going to measure to be young. If something is old, it's going to measure to be old.
Okay, so with that in mind then, that I should be able to look out in nature and have a reliable revelation there of how old things are. There do seem to be, though, a counterexample to that in Scripture. For example, God made Adam and Eve full grown. So doesn't that prove that he can make something with the appearance of age?
The fallacy there is you'd have to assume that Adam came from the womb of a woman. And the text tells us he did not come from the womb of a woman. God made him from the dust of the earth. And if he makes him from the dust of the earth, he can make him any size he wants, brand new. So I do believe that Adam was probably around 6 feet tall, but utterly brand new. And if I was a scientist measuring his age, I would have a magnifying glass up close to his face and look for tiny liver spots. I don't think I would have seen a single liver spot on Adam's skin the day that God created him.
So I think what you're saying is that God made Adam fully formed.
Fully formed.
But he hadn't gone through the process of becoming fully grown and going through
right.
the aging process.
He didn't grow from a baby up to a human being super fast. God made him fully functional, adult size, right away.
If I understand this correctly, if we were to maybe go back in time and we were to perform some scientific tests on Adam, maybe we test his blood, we would see that it's very pure. He doesn't have cholesterol resulting from aging. You test his skin, it would test like it was brand new. So there would be a way of reliably ascertaining that he was new. He was fully functional, but he was new.
Yeah, you're right on target, Krista. We use the most reliable methods for measuring the age of a human being, like cholesterol in the blood serum, like liver spot spreads over the skin. He would have measured to be brand new.
So it's different than saying it would be deceptive, that there would be no way of knowing that he wasn't aged, you know, that we would know that if we had a way of testing it.
Correct.
Okay, so that brings me back to the light travel thing. Because we can test it We know that's reliable. That's a revelation from God. We know that there's a way of looking at things to really know how old things are.
Correct.
Okay, very good. So it kind of reminds me of synthetic gems versus real gems. They look the same, it's fully functional, but if you were to test it, you could tell which one's newly formed.
Again, using the most reliable methods.
Okay, yeah. All right, I think I understand now. So when we're sharing our faith with scientifically minded people, why is it not a good idea to use an appearance of age argument?
Well, it violates the two books doctrine, that God reveals himself in a trustworthy manner through nature as well as through scripture. And when you're talking about appearance of age, you're basically saying to the non-Christian, the book of nature is not trustworthy and reliable, which is the opposite of what the Bible says about the book of nature.
So you're going to have a pretty uphill climb with them to tell them what they do know about the world isn't even reliable, and now you're going to try to get them to scripture.
Well, moreover,
that's going to be difficult.
Our goal as an evangelist is to use the book of nature to bring people to the book of scripture.
Got it.
And if the book of nature is not trustworthy, then how do we get people to the book of scripture?
Okay, that helps. I do want to encourage you to check out Hugh's blog. Just go to reasons.org and search for today's new reason to believe.